everyone, it's me, Miss Julie Vu, Princess Jules, Mother Sparkles, First Boot, whatever you want to call me, I'm that bitch. So today I'm here to talk to you guys about my transition update. If you are new to my channel, hello and welcome. This is a safe place where we talk all things, everything about Miss Julie Vu, her surgeries, her life, her transition, makeup, travel, everything. Please hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. Oh my God. I can't believe I almost forgot. My sex change surgery, the anniversary is coming up, April 28th. So today's the 19th, in 9 days. How old is she gonna be, 7 years old? Can you guys believe it?
I've had my vagina for 7 years?
7 years? Yeah, 7 or 8. 2014, I can't do the math. And you best believe I'm throwing a vagina party. Oh my God, I'm so excited. Oh my God, she's 27 years old. Hello, yoo-hoo. Maybe I'll feed her some cupcakes and a peanut. Back to the update. For those who are new to my channel, I was supposed to get facial feminization surgery and other surgeries April 1st of last year. But this coronavirus said, no you didn't, you ain't going anywhere, girl. And here we are. My surgery was canceled. I was supposed to fly over to South Korea to get my jaw done, my chin done, my eyes done, and my boobs done bigger. Now, when I tell people about these surgeries that I want to do, people usually say,
you're fine.
Or you're beautiful already. Or you're already passable.
Whatever it is, like, I appreciate you guys and it means a lot that you guys are so kind, but at the end of the day, I have to live with the body that I am in and I go through life with the experiences that I go through. Am I making sense? As a transgender person, gender dysphoria is a very real thing, and sometimes people who aren't trans will never know what it's like to look at yourself in the mirror and be like, I'm very unhappy about myself. This was me when I was a child. I would look in the mirror and just stare at my body and be like, I don't want this. I don't like this. Literally when I was a little boy, I took scissors, looked at myself in the mirror and was like, I'm going to cut my penis off because I hated it. You know, and this experience is something that you guys might never understand because you're not trans. When I had the opportunity to get a sex change at the age of 21, I was like, sign me up, get me on that table right now. Like, I didn't have a moment of like doubt or anything like that. No hesitation. I'm like, get me on that surgery table. I need this done. It was like a life or death situation for me. So anyways, when I talk about these surgeries about my face, like, I don't feel confident. It's hard to explain, but these are the things that I need to do for myself to feel comfortable in my own skin. Gender dysphoria is a very real thing. And so that is the reason why I want to get the surgeries done, because I don't feel 100%, if that makes sense. But anyways, this is me, myself, and I, and how I feel about myself. You might be comfortable in your own skin. I'm proud of you, I'm happy for you, but for others, it may be different. And I don't want you to judge anybody by their decisions in life. You know, this is my journey and it is completely different from yours or anybody else's. Going back to the surgeries in South Korea, no, I have not rebooked it yet because we're still in a pandemic and shit is crazy on the other side of the world. So it is on pause. And I hope to resume this process very soon in the near future. As for hormones, I have like a love-hate relationship with hormones. Like, it affects my body in weird ways. So I was on it, I was off of it, on it, off, kind of like my last relationship, just very rocky. I started taking estrace back in the fall time, but it really affected my skin. So I stopped taking hormones and then I was on the show. And now that I'm out of the show, off of the show, I'm slowly taking them again and seeing how my skin reacts. I don't know if my eczema flared up because of the hormones or was it because of winter and the cold weather. So now that it's getting warmer, I'm gonna try to see if it has any different effects. So I'm taking esterase, 4 milligrams of esterase. But yeah, so hormones, surgery update. My vagina is turning 7. So yeah, every year I have like 2 birthdays, my rebirth birthday, and then my actual birthday. So it's gonna be fun times. But yeah, what else? But I think that's it. I don't know what else to share. I don't wanna say that my transition is almost over because I feel like we never stop transitioning. I feel like it's a journey and you keep growing and you keep morphing and you keep changing. So I don't wanna say, oh, my journey's over, because it's not. But I feel like I've talked so much about my transition on my YouTube channel, like there's not a lot of new things to share. I mean, after my facial feminization surgery, that's gonna be some really good, juicy content, and I can't wait. Is it weird to say that I love surgeries? Okay, no, that came out really bad. I'm not addicted to surgery. I wouldn't say these are elective surgeries. I feel like these are very gender-confirming surgeries, if that makes sense. I don't know, I like the recovery process of like surgeries and how raw and how real the experience is. And I wanna share that with you guys, because when I started YouTube, there wasn't a lot of videos like that. And I'm so happy to see more videos on YouTube. I feel like it's a domino effect where, you know, if I post a video and then someone else shares their experience, and then that person shares it to 2 different people. And then now we have this huge community where people can feel comfortable about being themselves and learning information from multiple people, and it just makes me happy. So it makes me happy to know that I'm a part of the movement, the transgender movement and the LGBT pride movement. So that makes me happy. But anyways, I'm probably rambling on. I guess this video is more about like surgery update and gender dysphoria. But yes, I will be uploading more videos for you guys. I miss you all so much. And let's keep in touch. Follow me on Instagram at Miss Julie Vu or Twitter Princess Jules. I'll leave all the links down below in the info box. But thank you for watching, and I will see you guys very soon. Stay safe and stay healthy. Namaste. Bye.